Yeah, Detective Johnson, heat unit.
We received a tip that there was potentially a juvenile that was being sex trafficked. We had to figure out, one, is this in fact a juvenile? And if it is, we need to drop everything that we do to get her recovered as soon as possible. Without utilizing facial recognition, it makes identifying these juveniles nearly impossible.
When Clearview came along, that allowed us to search and to identify who they are, where they are.
We were able to take one of the photographs from the online advertisement, upload it into Clearview, and within seconds, Clearview was able to identify that individual.
I can attest for hundreds of kids that were identified using facial recognition technology.
It was a 16-year-old female juvenile who was being sex trafficked. We were able to get her immediately recovered out of the life, surrounded by resources, and her trafficker is currently sitting in prison.
My name is Kevin Metcalf. I'm the president and founder of the National Child Protection Task Force. We are an all-volunteer group. Everybody brings whatever tools they have with a focus on finding children who are in trouble. I got into prosecuting these cases and I just saw the horror that these kids had to endure. The investigators working the missing kid cases are underfunded, under-resourced, and overwhelmed. So that really became a passion for me to figure out how can we do this better and how can we do it faster. When you're dealing with child exploitation, a lot of times the only thing that we have is the face of a child. It's really pointless to run a 4 or 5 year old child through a driver's license database or mugshots. They're not gonna be there. So when Clearview came along, that allowed us to search the faces of children, and that is our last hope. That's the last chance this child has to be recovered.
My name is Wanton Tat. I'm the co-founder and CEO of Clearview AI. Clearview AI is a facial recognition search engine. When I was a kid, I was obsessed with electronics and computers. I'd be reading a lot of stuff on AI, especially around image recognition. The issues with the previous stuff, you'd have to get a perfectly aligned face. It wasn't accurate across all these different demographics. I'm a person of mixed race. Accuracy on this kind of technology is important to me. In my mind, I was like, that could be a solvable problem. We had this really amazing moment where we were trying a new neural network. Every single time, it would find the right person, different angles with masks and glasses. And that's when I realized we made the huge breakthrough in terms of accuracy. We're 99% accurate across all demographics, and it can pick a photo out of 12 million with a 99.85% accuracy. And that's when we knew that we had to then find the best and highest purpose for the technology itself. Originally, we were like, we don't really want to sell to police or governments, but it wasn't until we give it to law enforcement that it was really that wow moment.
Once officers started getting access to the technology, the word spread so fast. Seeing them deploy it through trials and pilots and the successes they were getting so quickly, as we're starting to receive feedback, we're learning that most of these investigators are in the crimes against children space. Being able to take an unidentified child that's being abused online and determine who they are, that's a needle in a haystack. So that's when we started realizing victims. That's where we're having a huge impact.
One of the important things to understand about Clearview AI, it only searches public information, right? We take a photo of a face that you upload and we turn it into a vector, which is about 512 points that the neural network extracts out. That vector then we search through an index of billions of photos on the internet. Then we get all the metadata information, the title, the link, where it was found originally, and return it back to the user.
My name is Chris Johnson. I'm a detective with the Reno Police Department, and currently I'm assigned to the Northern Nevada Human Exploitation and Trafficking Unit. We only have a certain window in order to identify these victims, and get these victims recovered before they move on. Traditionally, it was very tedious and it didn't quite always result in a positive identification. It could take hours, it could take days.
The longer it takes to identify a child and pull them out of that environment that they're in, the less childhood they have left. It's fading away minute by minute.
The ability to utilize facial recognition to help identify victims allows us to utilize our victim advocate to initiate resources immediately after they are recovered to get them out of the life and where they need to be.
Any new technology has some level of controversy. With Clearview AI, we welcome regulation of facial recognition technology. It's really important for us to get this right. So we have strong auditing features and many other controls in place to make sure that the technology is really used for the law enforcement use case.
Anytime that we do a search, we have to have our commission number or a case number attached to that and the reason for our search. And so that's able to be audited by supervisors to make sure that we're not misusing it.
What I've been able to discover is a real mission about having technology deployed for a public good and a public purpose.
When you're talking about an algorithm that is performing at almost 100% accuracy rates, then you're talking about a scenario where you can have better policing, better public safety, and situations that you can resolve that you couldn't resolve before.
This work, you truly are helping people. You are truly getting these victims out of the life, getting them help.
You cannot work in this for any length of time and come out undamaged.
It's not the low-hanging fruit. It's not the stuff that's really easy to do. But what's going to happen if we stop trying?